whistle seems fun. Let's see.
That sound is hardly pleasant. Do you actually know how to whistle, Ifri?
It's all soggy and smells like lake.
Thank you for allowing Master Mage Aus's spirit to rest.
Ah! Rhee! Another evil spirit resides here!
Sorry, I didn't mean to frighten you. I'm no evil spirit. I'm Rosalia. I witnessed you defeating the Master Mage who had lost her mind long ago. So I revealed myself to give you thanks.
But from the looks of you...
You're right. I am but a spirit. Unlike those evil spirits you've encountered around this place, though, I was lucky enough to keep my senses during the accident. Alas, those poor souls were once the town villagers.
Huh. A conscious, independent spirit. A rarity.
What happened to this town? What caused you to become like this?
This town never had many natural resources. Master Mage Aus showed us how to scrape by. We suffered, but we survived. God, however, couldn't bear to see us suffer. So she chose her messengers and brought us gifts. God graced the commoners with the ability to cast powerful spells so that they could keep the fierce monsters at bay and endure the harsh environment. God also taught Master Mage Aus the ritual of ascendancy. By the power of the well, once the ritual is complete, we could be freed from physical suffering, embracing true salvation and freedom.
But I don't think there's any salvation or freedom in your current state, huh?
2 years ago, Master Mage Aus led the ritual for the villagers. As our souls were about to separate from our bodies, someone broke the well in town, interrupting the ritual. Most villagers lost their minds in the accident, transforming into evil spirits that had no choice but to wander.
That explains the many evil spirits.
By salvation, you mean separating your soul from your body? That seems treacherous. Was it truly what God wishes for you?
Only Master Mage Aus and the other apostles could hear God's voice. I too have no inkling what God spoke. After becoming a spirit, I have been more relaxed and relieved than ever before. I don't need to sleep anymore, and I have forgotten the pangs from hunger. However, the ritual was incomplete. I can feel my life slipping away from me quickly. Yet nothing I do can reverse the flow.
Common spirits cannot eat, nor can they return to the stream. Ifri is sorry. Looking at you now, no one has the power or the knowledge to aid you. Even Ifri.
Your concern is most appreciated. It's been a long, long time now, and I've come to accept my fate. I cannot complain about my current predicament. It's all right. Let's dwell not on the past. Please pay a visit to my inn if you desire. I have gifts to express my gratitude. Welcome, honored guests. Thank you again for putting the Master Mage to rest. As well as granting me a chance to achieve my dream.
Dream? You mean...
I want to leave the town. I wish to see more of Ingarden.
Belus wasn't guarding the town. Why did you wait until now to journey beyond your little settlement?
After the ritual failed, its barrier remained. Master Mage Aus lost her mind and became the pivot of the barrier. Hence, it did not fall. The barrier crushed any spirit that attempted to leave the town. Weak spirits like me could not survive it.
Now that Aus is dead, is the barrier gone as well?
No. The barrier still exists. But its power is significantly weaker now. Therefore, if I break through now, I should be able to endure its effect. If I'm lucky, I could leave this place for good after paying the price.
But Ifri said that spirits cannot refill lost energy, nor can they return to the stream.
The price is using up what little life you have? Is it truly worth it?
This inn without guests requires naught of me any longer. And more, I don't want to merely wait for death to come to me in this deserted place. Mayhaps. The correct choice is to follow my heart for the little time I have left. Before I leave this world, I'd like to enjoy the sights of Ingarden a bit longer. Welcome, honored guests.
Dream?
Else, now that...
But the...
The... Thank you.
Thank you.
Gee, looks like we've stepped in a powerful magic circle. It's both protecting this place and watching us.
Madam once said that all the important places of Holy Grounds had similar enchantments before. They can stop armed invaders as well as monitor anyone who crosses the threshold.
My dear customers, this is merely a precaution. After all, in these troubled times, it is most important to protect yourself.
Wait, Rhee, aren't these the equipment and weapons we found on our journey?
Dear customers, don't misjudge me. The magic circle was summoned by a master mage of Holy Grounds. It can identify and sort various objects that enter within its boundary. After all, as an antique dealer, it is quite annoying keeping track of all this information myself. Many extraordinary objects exist in the world, but the information they carry is most valuable to me. Whether it be mysterious stories, elegant techniques, profound spells, or lost wisdom, these are the true treasures I seek. Sometimes I even find traces of God in them. Rest assured, the magic only identifies objects and projects them to me. It'll not harm your possessions.
I've checked it, Ifri. All the equipment in our backpacks is intact.
Ifri's never heard of such a spell. How strange.
I've seen so many interesting things about you. Please, accept this gift as an expression of my gratitude.
Wow! You do know how to please Ifri.
Welcome to my shop, dear customers. These are but a taste of my collections. Feel free to look around. If I may be so bold, the lad beside you would surely enjoy this words of Shenlong.
I'm not a lad. Show Ifri some respect. Who are you then?
I am Stanley, a simple merchant. There's no need to be hasty. How about perusing the store's collection before we speak further? dear customer. Dear customer.
The words of Shenlong? How did you find that?
What are you after? We spent a small fortune on that antique. Don't you dare try and take it away from us!
I, the Grand Fairy, wrote that book myself. Seems fate has guided you to the treasure I purposefully hid. In that case, I have a grand quest for you. Hidden within End Garden resides the Shenlong Glyphs, imbued with a mysterious power. Find all of them and hand them over to me.
We'll look for them on our adventures.
If the glyphs were really that powerful, maybe we can just keep them for ourselves.
I can hear you mumbling there. Little ones these days forget themselves. You should learn from your master. She knows proper etiquette.
I'm not her pet!
Aye, the Grand Fairy honors her word. Here's a gold coin for you as a prize. Find all the glyphs, and the gifts will be most generous. Collect enough coins, and I'll trade them for quite the items.
Hey, can you describe the glyphs?
Remember, I'm Sir the Grand Fairy, not Hey! Right behind my chair lies some information about the Shenlong glyphs. Read it at your leisure. Awaken me only when you have them all. Don't disturb me for any other reason, or you'll have to face my most horrible temperament.
Ifri, you seem unusually mewling when talking to Sir. That's rare.
Shh, keep your voice down. She paid us, so we help her in return. The Ifri. I call that a fair deal.
Oh, no longer using your own name? And you speak so cautiously. Could it be?
Ree, you only dare speak like this because you know nothing. Her aura is overwhelming. Let's take our leave.
I've never seen Ifri as frightened as he is now. Quite endearing.
What? I'm sleeping now! Wake me up only after you found my treasures!
Excuse me, I wish to see what is on offer. What does it say on the chair? Ifri, any idea?
I've seen nothing like it. Only that it bears a resemblance to the Shenlong glyphs we're looking for. Let's keep those shapes in mind.